This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. Are you able to see my screen now?
Yeah, I can able to see your screen.
Yeah. So before I want to starting SAP HANA, so most of the guests are confusing. So why? Because so HANA is the latest version. Even most of the guests are even who are working in SAP also, those are confusing. Like what are the module, what are the responsibilities? Everybody is confusing their topics. Okay, so as per your knowledge, what is meaning of SAP HANA? So is what type of product is? So any idea before?
Yeah, yeah, actually it is a columnar database. That means it is storing the in the column wise.
Okay, that I am storing in the column. Okay, fine.
Yeah, same thing is Oracle database is there. The different thing is there. It is storing the real cache in the RAM. It is not using the any hard disk to cache.
Yes, that is one more difference. Yes.
One more thing is there. The HANA, if you have a row label, then it is actually it is working as a analytics also, like analytic part also, OLTP part also, as okay. Like Oracle Database 12c and 18c is doing, same part HANA is doing.
Yes.
And the question is there, why I am going choosing the HANA now?
Yeah, that is
because I have some client which I am supporting them as a Oracle database as a part time.
Yes, okay.
Now no, they are
submission. Yeah, they are.
Yeah, they, now they are asking me to support the HANA also. They are going to be implementing the HANA.
Yeah.
So I have to learn that due to earn some extra money from them. I'm telling true.
Okay, that's good.
Please, sir, see, you teach me the basis, and I grateful to that. I got the good teachers, but I saw many person HANA demo, but they are not actually say that what is really HANA. Actually, HANA is a best practice for the columnar, and it is 80% data keeping the RAM.
Yes, that is okay, fine. Yeah. Okay, fine. So this is your knowledge on that SAP HANA. For example, now I'm a sales guy of SAP HANA. So now I want to recommend it for SAP HANA. So you are a customer. So you are a zero knowledge on SAP HANA. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm just salesman of SAP. I'm coming to just an example. I'm just saying here. So here you are asking two questions. What are the two questions you are asking? Why most of the clients are go for the SAP HANA? Right? What is the SAP HANA? Okay. So many guys are confusing this today. First of all, here, why you want to go for as a SAP HANA? The first reason. Sir, already have all traditional databases, then why you want to go for SAP HANA? Okay. And what is meaning SAP HANA? Okay, so at the end of the class, you have to clear these two doubts. Okay, so before that, even most of the guys are learning, also most of the guys, a lot of guys are confusing. Okay, so what is the confusion is nothing but here, what is the difference between the SPI 4 HANA? So some guys are providing the dead leg here, and some guys are saying as a yes. What is this difference?
That I saw in my client, they have implementing S-class 4 HANA.
Okay, yeah. That's okay, man. I'm asking you. Yeah,
yeah, I don't know this differences.
Okay. Any idea for because of even I'm sending the course content, even if you're searching some videos, those are saying as a telling a HANA administration, SPS04 HANA, SPS04 HANA, those are quoting like this. SPS04 HANA, S4 HANA, those are quoting.
Yeah.
Okay. So why most of the clients is here? Simply one basic thing here. So here, the difference between the SPS04 HANA and S4 HANA, both are different. Purely different, okay? So here, SPS04 HANA in calling as a application server. Like, as a business consultant, what is the software installing previously?
We have a network.
Yeah, you're installing the NetWeaver. Even suppose you are doing some advanced courses like SolarMan, so you are installing the ERP pages. Similarly, so SAP launching as a one more product, that is a S4. This is the front end. Okay, so anybody mentioned is S/4 HANA, that is called as a application service. So still I'm not agreed. Okay, I will explain that. Okay, anyway, so you say S4 HANA. Now I want to know what is the meaning of S4 HANA. So this is the database. Okay, so okay, both are different. So this is the front end, this is the back end. Okay, even sir, I want to like, so you say your client is implemented. The client is implemented. What is the version is implemented? See here, the version is, so this S/4 HANA is implemented around the 2015. Remember that date is very, very, because of most of the, this is this project you can calling as a upgradation projects. What we call?
Upgradation project.
Upgradation project. So means, so you say my client using as a S/4 HANA. So why those are using is nothing but suppose those are using as a ECC, RS NetWeaver, RS Solution Manager. So those are upgrading into the S/4 HANA. So in the topic, what is this topic in calling as? This topic in calling as a system conversion. What we call in calling as a system conversions. Okay, this topic that means it is the upgradation project. So your client is asking again, migration project. So what is meaning a migration project is nothing but not medication is a migration. Okay, migration project. So what do you mean a migration here? So means I want to changing as a non-SAP to SAP. Like my existing database is Oracle. I had to moving into the HANA DB. So my existing is the SQL. I had to move into the HANA DB. Okay, so this is called as a migration. Okay, remember this HANA database is implemented where 2011. Yeah, so means you are supporting is nothing but just assume. Okay, now my front end is the S/4 is nothing but you should be compulsory. Either you have to any database, this is application is your if you go for any other database also. Okay, so now I want to understand. So I have to suppose I'm sorry, drum diagram. The architecture is perfectly other. Now I have, you said two ends. The front end will be there and the back end also there. Okay, what is my front end here?
SAP S/4 HANA.
SAP S/4 HANA. So that is, you can say application server. Okay, and the database. Okay, database is the HANA database. So this is for means who are go for this type of landscape is nothing but. Okay, if you want to any project compulsor, two ends is required. Front end is required and back end will be required. Okay, so who are maintained this means? So this means who are implemented newly. Okay, who are doing as a new implementation. For example, now I want to start the project for 2017, 2015, 2016, then SAP is recommended. So you want to buy this product from front end, back end is from the SAP only. Don't go for other companies. So this is called as a front end. Sir, is it not a mandatory? Remember, it's not a mandatory. It's up to our choice. So this is implementation because again, when you go for old version, again, you have a lot of break, but it's very costly. Okay. But again, client is paying, it is rather later. Okay. Now, when you go for as a, I'm saying, sir, upgradation. So what upgradation is nothing but now? Sir, my current data, my front end is, okay, front end application service either ECC server, okay, RSA, suppose like ECC or NetWeaver or solution and so on so version. And the database is?
Yes, Oracle or SQL Server or Sybase.
Yeah, any other, so any other product. So Oracle, some others, okay, fine. Now, so this kind of architecture previously started. And now what happened? So SAP is staying at 2011 only, those are saying. So after 2020 onwards, you don't supporting as a any other third party databases. Means, I'm getting any issues from the, so in Oracle letters, I'm getting an issue. You don't support it through SAP related issues. Then what happened? What happened? Then every client is
moving to the HANA.
So directly moving, so mean directly how to replace the Oracle database, directly how to installing Oracle database is possible? No. Why? Because of here, Oracle is very old and very strong database and huge amount of mesh. I think when you go for all Gulf countries are maximum using this Oracle.
Yeah.
Even in my experience, because of at April this year, I'm going for Riyadh. Okay, Saudi Arabia. So Riyadh. Okay, I see most of the clients still know there is no training center in SAP from the Riyadh. Riyadh is one of the richest cities. I think you know that. Okay.
Yeah.
But there is no training centers. Okay. In April only, those are launching at their first training center. That is us and me. Okay, so that's my first training, and even you're starting a new company from the SAP and the training institution, then you take the training. Previously, you have to training is like how those are taking the training is nothing, but you have to compulsory come to the Dubai location, you can take the training. So I'm asking why is you now implemented? That's why I'm just saying it. So in all Gulf countries, maximum all are using as a Oracle Labs and Oracle databases, most of the clients. Because it's very huge amount of student, you'd have a lot of customizations will be there. Even I'm frankly speaking, compared to SAP, Oracle is as big, one of the biggest customization. So as per your client, as per your business, you can do customization, a lot of customizations is there. But the storage wise application, right, that is a Oracle is very, that's why now SAP is moving into the, so now all who are existing Gulf countries also is moving into the SAP. The best client is, and we get the training from Boston, the client that is Almarai. You know Almarai, I think.
I worked that.
Yeah, so Almarai, what is the purpose of API? Well, Almarai have totally 135 products will be there. Like, so daily when you wake up in morning, you take the milk,
yeah,
water, this is all products. So previously, those are using as a, like some other, but now also those are using Oracle, but recently at 2017 only, those are moving into the HANA DB. Okay, then those are take the training for me and they're starting the first training into the SAP Riyadh. Okay, now that's okay, fine. That's good. Okay, now what we'll do, sir? So last 10 years and what I'm using as a okay, 10 years since I'm using as a Oracle database. Now, here this one was as a so how much of terabytes will be there? Just as a 100 terabytes of data will be there now. I want to remove this overall. It is possible. It is possible, but too much of data loss will be there. Means you have to remove the entire application. And then what happened? So back end, the process is going on. So what happened? The existing customer, what those are doing? Those are existing into those are buying as HANA DB as well as those are testing as those data also. So this project, what we call?
The migration.
Calling as a migration project. So miss, so daily when you log in, now what happened? Who are working as ACC and backend and okay, the data is storing. And here, simultaneously, what are the data will be, everything is replicated automatically at the end of the day into the HANA DB. Because after 2 years, I've not using Oracle. So everything is replicated because we have some replication tools also there. So this is the migration. This is you can calling as a migration project. Why most of the guys? Because of, so here, I had to pay the license from this guy and I had to pay the license from this guy. Instead of I want to go for two guys, I want to maintain only one guy. Means the front end and back end is maintained by the only one guy only. Okay, so this is the migration. Means the front end is anything that our database will be supporting. Okay, this is called as a migration project. Clear? Then go for as a upgradation project. What is meaning upgradation? I already told that.
Yeah.
So you have to move into the, suppose your existing company you're using as a latest version of ERC, enhancement package 8, even ERP product, enhancement package 8, ERP 6.0. Okay. So this is my existing. So now what happened is the latest version like from the ERP wise. Okay. Then what happened? Then I want moving into the SP4 for 2015 onwards, starting version. Then this project you can calling as a implementation project, as a upgradation. The topic you can call as a system conversation. There's a new topic, okay? Upgradation project. Now, sir, now I want to running as a S5-4. What are the databases required? Now, what are the databases there here?
HANA DB.
Once you're migrating HANA DB also, you should be, so if you want running with S5-4, you should be compulsory running as a, okay, HANA DB. Okay? Should be compulsory running as a HANA DB. Okay, so even if you want to go for other databases supporting, but the performance wise, okay, even dynamic wise, the front end back end will be supported. Okay, this is called as an upgradation. Now, so every client is doing as a, not implementation is very rare condition. So already existing client, those are moving to the HANA DB, are newly implemented from new applications. So still I'm confusing what we're saying. So why are you confusing? Because of you wanted the version number. So see here, SY4 HANA starting versions are SAP HANA. Okay, SAP HANA. So first version is 1.10. Okay, next version is SAP HANA 16.10. Okay, next one, SY4 HANA 70.09. SY4 HANA 18.09. You know these are the installation also. Because previous install network, same process installing this also. Okay, these are the versions from S by 4. Okay, now see here, now you take the training. So what are database versions? At least you do some R&D. Like what are the database versions is there? S4 HANA 1.0, starting version is SPS02 till. So now we take the training for which database you want now? Sir, S4 HANA 1.0, sorry, 2.0. So SPS03. So this is the current version that is implementing 2018. So versions are also different or not?
Yeah.
Okay, so these are the, now clear? So what is the difference between the S5.4 and S4? So what are the training you're taking? So you take the training from HANA database. Clear?
Yeah.
So please don't take the S5.4 again, because already you know the installation file. Yeah, so how we can install it as a normal system, same process. That's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. You know, installation, like NetKeeper, Solution Manager, anything. Remaining all your system will be separate. Just click on next only. But you want to know what are the components you want to download and able to.
Yes.
Okay. Now clear? Okay, fine. So this is the difference between the S5.4 and even, sir, when you're downloading also, okay, when you're downloading also, the difference will be there. For example, this I'm showing you how you can downloading those software. HANA database software downloading is different, and this software download is different. So see here, what is software is there here?
S4 HANA, SAP HANA, okay.
Yeah, so here, S4 HANA, what are the versions is there here?
16, 17, 18, 09.
Now current version is?
Well, this one, okay.
Okay. Okay, now. Okay, even now I want to suppose now I want to installing any SAP software. What are how many components is required? You remember or not? What are the software is required? I want installing SAP software front and back end. What are the systems is required?
That I need to be all the packages.
Yeah, what is the packages name? So you are requiring as a installation exports. Okay, see, these are the installation exports. So first of all, you're requiring, so I want installing the front and back end, so requiring as any SAP software installation, requiring the five component. The first of all, latest kernel file. Second thing is the installation export. Third one is the database. And next one is the database client. And next one is the SWPA. So these are the five softwares you require to installing any SAPs.
But I hear that this is only supporting Linux.
Which one? No. Just this is a Windows is also there. Remember, this is a Windows also there. Oracle database is Linux.
Okay.
So Oracle sorry. HANA database is the Linux.
Okay.
So you are installing as this Windows machines also. That's why for you installing to Windows. That's what I'm saying. This applications are installing is Windows, but database should be compulsory. We're installing as only on SUSE Linux.
It is not supporting any other Linux, huh?
No, it's supporting Solar is supporting, Red Hat is supporting, everything is supporting. So, but most of the guys are using as a Solar SUSE Linux. Solar says you can download the free versions also, one thing of installation. And these are you can install front end installing as a Windows also support. Okay. There is no specification. Now clear, what is the difference between, even see here when you're downloading also, So what are the softwares you want to download? So here, SAP HANA 2.0, that is a S/4HANA premise, that is a client from database side. Okay, this is for downloading as a S/4. Okay, suppose now I want to downloading as a HANA DB. Again, you're discussing the installation, just I'm recapping. Okay, because of most of the guys are confusing what type of training you're taking, what are versions you're taking, why are you taking this training? And most of even the training institutions will be confusing, and even more for the trainers also will be because they don't have the real-time experience, just knowledge-wise, those are going. Okay. So see here now my lowest new series. So here now S/4 is registered. Now see here has been package solution manager. Now come back to here. HANA. So HANA, what is the latest version here?
2.0.
2.0 SAP HANA platform. Means I say now S/4 is different now. Okay. Now see here when this implemented, this is the 2016. Okay. So go for technical information. Now you're asking now what type of, say, HANA database, HANA client, HANA actual, HANA. So these are the components inside of HANA DB. Okay, even now come back to here. I want to implement this. Okay, so upgradation from, where is upgradation? So take the upgradation from.
One, two
is not available because there is no register. Okay. So I want installing this. What are the add-ons you can install on top of that? So these are the add-ons in HANA DB. Any S/4 is there? You mentioned? Nobody mentioned S/4.
No, yeah. I don't have now.
Yeah.
But the client is S/4 implementing.
Hmm? Yeah, S/4 is the front end. Okay.
And yes, S/4 HANA is there.
Yeah. So here. So what is the latest version of HANA DB? SAP HANA 2.0, that is also support pack. What is support package? SPS03 00 01 02 03. So 03 is implemented for 2018 April just. Okay, now I want to go for download the software. Same how we can last time you doing how to downloading Oracle database, same process. See here. Okay. Now see here, what are the CSN? So what are the power missions? Is it now I want to SPS03. What are the component you want to downloading here?
HANA platform edition. And then this exe file.
I want installing as a HANA DB. What are the components? Is it what are the components you got downloading?
Actually, okay. I don't have idea.
No, just read that here. So here,
okay.
Now I want to downloading HANA DB. So these are the four components. Why this four software is required? Read it. Okay, SAP HANA 2.0 SPS, revision number 31, 1/2, 2/3. Why those are? Because of the service for maximum suffices 4 GB moment. So that's why those are making it. This is for Linux normal machines. Okay. So now I want to go for power missions. Like you want taking the hardware, certified hardware, like IBM is providing.
Yeah, IBM. Okay.
Linux and power missions.
Okay, power.
Okay. And you say this is all on any SUSE Linux, anything. This is this. Again, Linux old versions, revision 30, revision 32 power mission. Those two only two type, remaining everything is done. Clear?
Okay, clear. How I will get the prerequisite of the installation of the Linux?
Which one?
Because I'm going to install the line.
Okay. What way the prerequisite is, just your minimum 32 GB RAM is required. That is a prerequisite. Remaining nothing limited. Or even you can downloading as a Linux from the open source. It's open source. You can download it. And I will give the software. Then you can download it. So the minimum just hardware is important. Should be minimum 32 GB is there. Then you can install it as a information source. Okay.
Okay.
Now clear this?
Yeah, clear.
Now I want to go for, so why we want to go for as a HANA database? So already you raised the questions, or already you have Oracle database is there. Oracle database of column storage will be there. Okay. So even if you say some column storage element in memory computing, that is just that why you want to go for HANA DB. So here, first of all, I want to know the first of all, what is the drawback of the, okay, the drawback of traditional databases. Okay. So even, okay, what is the drawback of traditional databases is nothing but, here, when you go for old, when you go for 20 days or 20 years back, okay? So what is the purpose of database? So because Oracle database is around 1990 to 2600, so it's available. So why are you requiring the database actually?
To save the record in the...
Yeah, so you have to save that because it means the purpose is majorly you have to perform as a just storing the data. Okay, so this is my XYZ. All this is my traditional database. Okay. Traditional database. Now, for example, I had to go for some supermarket like a Walmart, or you can go for as a some registration. So, as a customer, what will do? So, as a customer, first time I'm visiting, okay, how the data will be storing. First time visiting, how the data will be stored? So my customer information. So I have to contact Supergram. What are the items will be there? That everything will be storing into the
database.
That particular database. Okay. Sir, what is the advantage of traditional databases? The advantage of traditional databases is nothing but when the data will be inserting, you can say writing is very fast. Writing the data is very fast. Okay, then I want means this is what I'm writing here. So you want to, first of all, the create command is up. Okay, and after that, inserting is up. The data will be inserting will be there. Okay, that is two. Again, the customer is coming second day, third day, fourth day. Then what happened? Same data here again, create command is executed. No.
Yes.
No, create is not. Again, it's what we do, update is
update.
Update will be updated. Okay. That's also fine. Now, what is my requirement? Same. So here, so last 10 years onwards, I want to preparing the customer information. I want to preparing the some reports. Yeah. Sir, why you want to preparing report? Again, question. So here, my question is, I want to prepare last 10 years. I want to preparing the so also customer information. How many transactions is done? What are the transaction? I want to overall records. Okay, that is my requirement. Okay. So here, why you're requiring this at part? To improve your business. For example, every day when you go for any supermarket, what happened? Every day they're putting some offer. Why is it putting offer? Because sir, you have a lot of demand, so you have a lot of accommodation in business. Okay, you should be compulsory putting some up, otherwise the business will be lost. How you know that you're putting this particular product, this particular offer? Because every day I want to prepare the analysis report. How we can prepare the report? Based on the database. Okay. So otherwise, what happened? Suppose I'm not putting the report for daily, I'm preparing it yearly or quarterly, what happened? You don't getting the proper business. Means now every business is running as a analytic is very important. Okay. Yes, so that's why what happened, even the banking guys are also what happened? Every month those are making the statements. So otherwise, what happened every year, those are making statements is nobody is doing that bank. Because even so the target of the customer is, first of all, is requiring the storage. Okay, the all traditional, this futures is very perfectly from the all traditional database. Like we have Oracle database and the SQL server, SQL database, okay, and MaxDB. Okay, these are the traditional DB2 database, and even Sybase. Okay, these all databases is very perfectly for writing the information into inserting, okay, updating, everything is perfect, it is very fast. But here, when you're preparing the report, means preparing the report is nothing but first of all, what we do? I want to read the, reading this information from this particular database is very slow. Okay, so here the drawback of traditional pattern is reading. When you retrieve the data from the database is very slow because sir, 10 years data is there. So 10 years data I want to preparing as if for last 1 year, last 3 years. This is very, very difficult. Best example, an example, when you go for as a, some foreign countries, so suppose you have to go for as a visa process, what are the documents is required? So the guy is asking as a, so last 5 years onwards your bank statements.
Yeah.
Okay, so last 5 years your bank statements is required. And so now, sir, I have internet banking is there, so I want to log on internet banking, then I have to download this 5 year statements. Is possible?
It's possible.
Internet bank. 5 years data.
It's not. They're not allowed.
1 year is okay. Maximum is 6 months, or that is also even if you paid it, you have to get in 1 year. Now suppose I want a 10 years data, 10 years statement. Is this possible? No. Then what we'll do? So I want to go for bank. Okay, I want to go for bank. I want to contact the bank manager or clerk. Those are having the, all the details. Okay, those are giving us all 10 years report, then you can start. So here, what is the reason? So why is it putting at 1 year? Because there is a fresh data. Okay, means the fresh data where is maintained. So this 10 years data, those are storing into the database level, DB. Okay, and where is it? Like this say 6 months, 1 year, 1 month, 2 months, particularly fresh data. Where does will maintain? So that will be maintained into the some warehouses. Okay, some warehouses softwares. Means I want to preparing as a report within fraction of seconds. You are using two serve. One is you are using the database as well as a I want to retrieve the database pretty fresh data. Then what we'll do? So I am making some warehousing concepts also. Means you have to maintain either two different softwares. One is the warehousing one way as well as a database is one way. Then what happened? So you have to require a database consultant as well as a warehousing consultant. The maintenance is very difficult. Okay. This is the one first drawback of those are upstream when implementing as SAP. This is the first means I want to retrieve the data from the database is very slow. Okay, even when you go for as YouTube, WhatsApp, Skype or anything. So, so when you go for YouTube, just assume how many billions of videos will be there. So within the billion videos, okay, now I'm just searching. Okay, I'm typing top 10 movies in my so and so, Tollywood, Bollywood, Hollywood or something. Now within fraction of seconds, you're getting as a Yeah. So means here the customer want while customer server want. So you want a lot of storage required as well as a within a fraction of seconds. I want to get the data from your database. Okay. So then those type of drawbacks. Okay. So those type of drawback, what happened? Then SAP HANA will be started. Just not only one, I will explain that. This is one of the busted means what the first drawback SAP, sorry, traditional database. When you retrieve the data from the database, it is very slow. Okay. So that's where they're implementing as a SAP HANA. Okay. So yeah, what a verb of SAP HANA is, you're just naming as a high performance. Naming as is actually is one virus name. I'll give you the virus name study when you go by chicken. Okay, high performance. Name meaning only first here, analyticals. Analytic, who prepared analyticals?
Analyticals.
Analytic, who prepared BWS are preparing as analytic, like who are working in a data, not database, who are working in a, okay? BW or warehousing, those are getting as analytical and appliance, what application expanded, okay? Now, here, those are the HANA. Sir, what is the HANA DB, okay? So, you know that HANA is a database that is a like, perfect, all right? But here, what is the HANA DB is made up of? Okay, so here the HANA DB is made up of a. There is no new invention for HANA also. Just those are combining the three technologies. What are the three technologies here? The first technology you say now. What is the drawback of first one? What is the drawback of first one? So the data traditional data when you're reading the data from the database is very slow. Yeah. Then what happened? Those are adapting. SAP HANA is there is no invention. I'm saying those are adapting as a one technology. The technology you can calling as a TREX engine. I think you have to listen to this in naming also.
TREX engine.
Okay. Okay. So means to avoiding as a okay means I want to redo the data from the database. I want to getting it within fraction of second you are running this software. So here, what is the purpose of this software? So and this is the full form is TREX engine is nothing but text retrieval. Say text retrieval.
Text retrieval.
okay, exception. Okay, exception. This is implemented by the at 1996 only, one of the college student. So why is implemented? Because it's one of the academic project. Okay, is implementing this technology. Okay, after that, nowadays this TRX is using the search engines. Even Google is using this engine only, the search engine. Sir, what is the purpose of this? So what is the purpose? This is the, you want to read, you want to reading the data from the database is very fast. Means I want installing this TRX engine in my database, then within fraction of seconds, I want to get the data. So how it is get the results? For example, I'm taking some popular websites. So Google, sir, how will you say Google is using the TRX engine? Well, you have any free time, is it just check it, TRX engine, Wikipedia. Okay, one of the college students has implemented this. Okay, now I'm searching this some what? Okay. I'm searching, what I'm searching here?
Facebook.
I'm just go for either Google search engine. I'm just typing as one keyword. What is the keyword I'm typing?
Facebook.
The Google server through Google database, maybe so you're getting this results. So how getting this results? Because of this keyword, how many members will be typing this keyword within 0.4 millisecond? Okay, this type of results is getting how it will be based on the TRX engine. Okay, this is the one of the okay, this first technology for HANA. Next one is the next component, okay. Next one is the P square tag, okay. P square, you can call P, this is P square. P square. Okay. Sir, what is the software again? Okay, so what is the software is something? Well, again is one of the okay P square. Okay. It is one of the lightweight. Lightweight database software. So what is the purpose of this is nothing but I want to writing also already our traditional database when writing is very fast. Okay, so when installing this P score software tool, then what happened? So again, that when you're writing the data is very fast compared to normal databases. Okay, already our traditional databases is advantage is there. What are our databases means? So you want to writing, inserting, creating, updating is very fast. Even I want to begin most, like me, I want to getting in within fraction of seconds compared to even if you're inserting, updating this one very fast, implementing as a one more software that is called as a piece code tag. Okay, this okay, means the traditional databases, you know, compared to traditional database, you have reading and writing is very fast because of those are added as a two software. Whether two softwares here, TRX engine and piece code tag. Okay. So one more most important is a combination of one more, that is the MaxDB. So what is the purpose of MaxDB here? Normally, what is the purpose of MaxDB? So the MaxDB is for storages. So here, but here, why you're using as a MaxDB software? Here, this is for only for backup and recovery purpose. Why are you taking as a backup and recovery? Okay. Okay, so this HANA DB is a, there is no invention. What are those doing here? Those are combining the three technologies. What are the three technologies that are combining here? So TRX engine, as well as the P-Square tag, as well as the MaxDB software. These three softwares are combining and making one software that is the HANA DB. Okay. So you say, you say, what is the purpose of MaxDB is nothing but here. So MaxDB is means here, again, I want to getting one question. So what is the meaning of database here? What is the meaning of database?
Here, the really combine of three product to be gone to database.
Yeah, that is not because I'm saying normal traditional database. I'm just discussing
a traditional database. Is a row and column format and storing the data.
Don't go for that much of it. I'm just asking as what is meaning of database?
It's a collection of information.
Okay, collection of credentials of any other. Collection of information. Why you want to go for as the database?
To keep the records. Storing the records.
Okay, storing the records. Okay, so already you have the drives also, then a C drive, D drive. So everything is there. This is also this is also database. But why you want to go for as this is actually what we call?
Actually, it is not a database. It is a spinning storage, we called.
Yeah, it is a, you can call it a file system.
File system.
So you can call file system is, so how to make it this file system as a database? Sir, I want, so suppose I want to be making a, this E drive as a database. What we'll do? I had installing as any type of database or DBMS tool, and I've been making it. This is the database. Okay? Means, yeah. Where we store this overall data? Means I had installing as a file system. Where is it? Where is the file system also is available? Means, where is this overall data will be storing in the format of? Where we store? In the format of? Hard disk only. Okay. Means now I am installing as a HANA. Sorry, I am installing as any iteration first one. What is specification is required here? The hardware is hard. The hard disk can check it. Okay. That is fine. Then, okay, that is fine. Now here, recently, what is the data I'm accessing? This is the for permanent storage. Like suppose now I have 1 terabyte is there. 250 GB movies, songs, everything is there. Now I want to play so and so movie. Okay, how this process is going up? So first of all, the hardware, the hard disk, whatever that is, everything pushing into the RAM, RAM to CPU, then is playing into the representation.
Yeah.
Okay. So means what happened here? The data will be retrieved from your hard disk to where is processing? Where is processing?
The RAM and. To the CPU.
Data is retrieved from your hard disk to?
Hard disk to RAM.
Okay, RAM to where is going at?
To go to processor.
To processor. What do you mean CPU? Okay. Central user processor. Central processing unit.
Yeah.
Okay, then he's getting a display. Okay. Yeah. But here, once when he is restarting, what happened? The RAM, what type of data is there? Everything is the? What happened? Okay, it's not a volatile. Once you restarting automatically, that everything is clean up.
Yeah.
Okay. This is the normal. But here in external hard disk, what type of data is it? That is a permanent. Okay, even if you're restarting also, what is the last saving point? That is everything will be there. Even if you have crashes anything, the hard disk is that in case require restarting everything first. But you take one thing. Well, you told one thing. Whatever you told, sir, first of all, SAP, as you say, everything data will be storing in the format RAM only.
Yeah.
Okay, now you're getting one question. Okay, what the question is there? The first question, why the MaxDB technology is implemented? And second question is, sir, you say the overall data will be storing in the format RAM only. Now you just know you saw that. Okay, you just know this. Once you have to restart your computer system, auto in the RAM, what type of data, everything is removing.
Okay. Yes.
Then at that time, what happened? So first of all, again, same process here. So now I had inserting as a overall data, okay, overall data from the even like your SAP HANA DB is storing as a RAM only. Okay. Mm-hmm. And what is the purpose of external hard disk? So it's only for backup and recovery purpose. Okay. Now you say, okay, so when you store, when you go for as a RAM, once you say, overall data will be storing the RAM, once you are restarting, what happened? The automatically what happened that will be erasing. Okay, but here, coming to SAP HANA, what happened? So that overall data will be storing into RAM. Simultaneously, the data will be automatically storing into the external hard disk also. I mean, this is called as a synchronization and synchronization. Okay, the data volume as well as a log volume. So everything is storing into the automatically synchronizing into the hard disk. Now what happened? So now just suppose I'm synchronized is going on. Unfortunately, the system will be crash. Now what happened automatically?
By the time,
So here at that time, what happened? So at the last save point, okay? RAM has to say, what is the last save point? Like actually every 300 seconds, you want to put in some, so if you're putting in 60 seconds, 10 seconds, okay, everything is synchronized to the hard disk. Okay, last save points, okay, that is just your recovery. So that's why HANA DB will be having the 0%, okay, destroyed. Okay, so here, what is those implementing MaxDB is nothing but because only for backup and recovery restoring purpose. Because of what are the storage is my HANA DB, like analytical, anything, everything is synchronized, automatically synchronized into the MaxDB, so directly to the MaxDB software. Okay, during installation, you have to do the sizing for RAM as well as the hard disk. Okay, here the hard disk is, this is only for the, what the purpose hard disk is for, only for the, so you only for backup and recovery purpose. Okay. So this all future, this all softwares are combining, making as a one software. That is the HANA DB. So once conclusion for this. So here, what the HANA DB is making as? So HANA DB, you can using as a read. First of all, reading purpose. How it is very reading is very fast because it was implementing the TRX engine component. Okay. And writing also. How the writing will be for? So already there is something. Okay. Already. So you say 0 point. Most of the guys are asking as 0% 0% destroyed. So already you have the implementing one more component, that is the for backup and recovery. Okay. So this is a HANA DB main features. So means any query say what is meaning HANA DB is HANA DB is made up of three components. Those are the TRX engine, P square, and Max DB. So TRX is for the reading purpose. P square time is the writing purpose, and MaxDB is for backup and recovery purpose. Okay, so this is the meaning of HANA DB. Now, so how it is very high because that is the remaining features. Okay, remaining, what are the features is there? So you say, so here coming back to here, so now I'm clear what is meaning of HANA DB. HANA DB is made up of this component. Now, so in HANA DB, what are the components will be there, and what are the main features is there? So here, why is getting as a because of here high performance analytical appliances, but analytical for already know that there is the preparing means the database on can prepare. Appliance. What is meaning appliance here? Any idea?
It is a hardware.
Yeah, so it's a combination. For example, washing machine is there. Washing machine is appliance or not?
Yeah, appliance.
So why you say suppose I want to go for any offer or home appliance? So what are the home appliance category will be there?
Freeze, TV, refrigerators.
Yes. It means here, what is the meaning of that here? You can say appliance is nothing but combination of hardware as well as the software. People are installing as a, see here. So why those are installing as a, okay, both are installing as a true RAM only because of the data will be accessing is very fast. So how it is saying is very fast. Will be go for one by one. Okay, the software image here. So that's what I'm saying. Hardware. So you have to. So what is the hardware here? The hardware is provided by the your hardware vendors. Should be compensated taking the certified hardware vendors only. Okay, and when you go for the software, that is provided by the SAP only. Okay, SAP HANA. So this two all combining installing as a true RAM only. True RAM only. Okay. So here, coming to here, what is the event? So how your computer is working on, how the traditional database is working on, compared to traditional database, your computer, how is it working, it will be open one by one. Now clear this?
Yeah, but I have one question.
Yes, tell me.
Suppose I have a 2 terabytes of data.
Yes, okay.
How you will just, this 2 terabyte will go for the 2 terabytes of RAM? This is, I have one of the, I'm thinking last few month.
So you have 2 terabyte.
Suppose 200 terabytes data.
200 terabytes of data is there.
Okay, we are now migrating to the slowly to HANA.
Okay.
So what will be the RAM?
So here, for example, just assume as a terabyte, suppose a Oracle database something. So once when you're migrating into the HANA, so the terabytes are coming to here, 20 without any data loss, because of the HANA DB having is one of the features that is the compression rate. So 10% of your compression rate will be there. Yes. Now current existing database. Yeah, I will explain that. How the compression will explain that. Okay. Okay. Do the sizing will explain that. Okay. Now you can say, okay, even sir, I want to go for 20 terabyte also. I am requiring either 22 terabyte of RAM is required. Okay. Means you have to go for a 20. So maximum the tabs, maximum RAM is available only 1 terabyte RAM.
No, 3 terabytes.
Is also there, varies.
Yeah,
I don't know. Now I can like maximum
RAM I am using as a 4 terabyte one server.
4 terabyte
of RAM, 4 TB of RAM.
4 TB of RAM means how many blades will be there?
Not blade, it is a one of the IBM server, IBM Power 9 memory.
Okay,
and we are running on that and the Oracle database.
Yeah, so that's why you can go for as a 4x5. Then it's a 20 terabyte. So then you're taking the file system. Hello?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm with you, sir.
So see, you are taking the file systems.
Mm-hmm.
So the file system, suppose you say all are interesting, yeah, you are interesting only single machine. So that is called as a one you can making as a master, remaining are working in a slave configuration. One is a master, remaining all are the slaves. Means, suppose now we have say 5 blades will be running continuously. Suppose any blade will be not working automatically, that is going to other one. That is called as a cluster configuration.
Yeah.
You know, Oracle database you can calling as RSC concept.
RSC, right. Yeah.
Yes. Okay, similar you can think either here, master slave configuration. Okay.
It is every server has a slave, or inside the one server we are making the master and slaves?
Inside of the one server you can make the slave. Like you can call it instances. 00 instance, the master remaining are the slaves. So like one application, you have to go for distributed boxes. In same server you can make the slaves. Okay, even the hardware also, you can make it the blades only, 4 dB, 4 dB, pure dB. When you come into hardware wise, you can go for as a blade. When you go for software wise, you can go for as a hardware, like a master and slave configurations. So now means, so one blade, like a one blade, you can use like a one blade, you have 4 GB is there, like you have to go for 5 blades, you can go for a single machines.
Okay.
Okay. Now see here, so how your computer is working on, or how SAP computer is working, SAP HANA computer is working on. For example, now I have the, your presentation is there, and I have CPU core processor will be there, and processor will be there, and you have RAM also there, and I have external hard disk also there. Okay. So this is here, processors. And this is for RAM, and this is for even this. And this is even presentation. So how the normal computer is working? Suppose now what happened last 10 years I'm using as a my laptop or something. Okay. So last 10 years onwards I'm using as a means around 2009 onwards, okay, 2019, I'm buying a laptop. So now what happened? Total 10 years of data is available. Mm-hmm. 10 years of data, so total size is just assume as like a 1 terabyte data is available. Okay, 1 terabyte is available. Now, okay, I want to so play the so and so movie. Okay, how the process is going up? Now I want to play in my computer. I want to play this some movie. Okay.
Yeah.
This is the 4 GB. This is the single core or dual core. You know how the computer is working? So now come back here, what happened? So now I want to play the movie. First of all, what happened? The request is directly what happened. The request is going to where external hard disk means particular drive on that. Okay. So now here I want to play the 3GB file. The movie says it's 3GB, but here what are, how much is that here? After one terabyte. Okay, 1 terabyte. What happened? That 1 terabyte data will be pushing into the RAM. Okay, all 1 terabyte. This is, there is no application. There is no filtering here. All will be, what happened? The 1 terabyte data will be pushing into the your RAM. Now what happened? The RAM size is 4GB. Okay, so now what happened? The bulk amount will be moving automatically. What happened is getting as a bottleneck.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And even RAM to your processor, and you're getting a response on that. Okay, same process. Suppose my overall data will be storing as a RAM only. Okay, so same configuration. What I'm doing here, I'm increasing the RAM speed. The RAM also 1 terabyte, and the hard disk also 1 terabyte. Okay. Okay, hard disk also 1 terabyte, overall 10 years data. And here I'm using as a multi-core processor, not single core processor, because of in when you go for Intel only have x86 configuration will be there. There's a multi-core processor, means multiple CPU server. Okay, and when you go for as a presentation, now what happened? So the user is be login. I want to log in, I want to play this home. So over here, overall 10 terabyte, okay? So 1 terabyte data will be fetching into RAM. Here, what RAM had happened? That will be filtering, okay? So overall 1 terabyte data is moving. Out of this, I want to processing was only 3GB on that, okay? The 3GB will be moving into the processor, process to getting the presentation. First of all, is log on to the RAM only, because the HANA computer is working with means overall data will be storing in the RAM, even accessing also RAM. So now here, the application logic also, the filtering also performed by here only, because analytic also is performed here only. Okay, then data will be pushing into the 3GB, pushing into multi-core processor. Multi-core, i4, i6 means suppose I have 4 processor will be there. Now here I have 3GB, each process taking 1GB, even till 1G, one core is free, okay? Then what happened? Within fraction second, the data is moving into the core. Within fraction seconds, it's getting there. So this is the normal computer. Here, what is the purpose of this here?
It is for saving.
So just see how to pushing the data from here to here.
But okay. In case of, suppose your data is 20 terabytes.
Yes.
How you are going to configure the RAM?
Which one? Yeah, you can giving as you are taking as a 20 terabyte
data.
Okay, hard disk.
Yeah. Okay, that is data, total data is in hard disk is 20 terabytes.
Sorry, hard disk size is?
The total data size is 20 terabytes.
Okay, the actual data is 20 terabytes. So how the data will be increased inserting into the RAM? That is the question. Yeah. Okay, then you can go for as a 20 petabyte RAM. So here I like to own the formula. You can say now 4 into 5. So you say actually here in standard process you have only standard, like you have RAM sizes are XS is very small, medium, and large. Large is a max means 1 terabyte only. Okay, so medium is nothing but 512 GB RAM. S is for 215 GB RAM. XS is nothing but very small, 128 GB RAM. Okay, you have to just multiply on that. Even so, here you're maintaining as a 20 terabytes of RAM. So similarly, can depending as a double of the maintaining your hard disk, 40 terabytes of your hard disk. That is not a can calling it a SSD transfer. The some formulas is, I will explain the formulas. Okay, now how this diagram will be breaking is like how the normal computer, what the difference between normal computer as well as a traditional computer. Check. things. So what is the difference observed for this computer and this computer?
Okay, CPU memory bus and it is consuming to the database. Okay, here is a memory row column and partition. Okay, compression. Okay, it is doing the partition and compression also. This one,
yeah,
the multi-core architecture.
Yes, I will explain that. That is what I'm saying. Previously, I'm saying once you want to migrating into the oracle, your current existing database is the so and so GB. For example, I have 1 terabyte, 100 terabyte GB there for Oracle DB. Once you want to migrate into the SAP HANA, HANA is converting to the 10 terabytes. So that 10% of compression rate. Okay. Yeah, now see what the difference you observe from here and here.
Okay, it is bulk time, it is pushing to data to the disk.
Yes,
here is not pushing, but okay, same architecture. Okay, some anything document is there from the SAP side how to lay out the memory and CPU.
Which one
is there? Any document from the SAP how to prepare the layout? Suppose one company we are going and we have to prepare one layout or give them this much of RAM required, this much of hard disk required.
Yeah, that is you can discussing about that, because of here the layout you have to, first of all you want to know existing one, then you could first suppose that you had, first of all there is a new implementation or migration or is incorporating normal systems, based on that you can preparing the layout. Okay, so that is coming to the pre-installation. For example, so see here she had two types of sizing. Is there two types of sizing here?
Data migration, database migration and new implementation.
Database migration is nothing but?
It is from the traditional database Oracle Sybase to the half SAP HANA.
Yes. So here, these are the node numbers you can check. Okay. Mm-hmm. Even how the formulas will be there, how we can check. So this is, so here, first of all, what is this example that is showing as?
Here the suite HANA sizing in the GB. Total memory required to 2 GB.
Like simple finance. This is the normal max. Okay. Then how much hard disk is there? How much you can there? You can preparing this thing. So even you can go by using the quick sizer tool, you can prepare this overall layout. Even transition code basis, you can prepare this layout. Okay. So here, yeah, this is just formula RAM static and RAM dynamic. Okay. And what is size of that? Okay. This all document, the formulas will be there. That's what I'm saying. You want this overall formula based on the formula only can add. For example, so that is a quick sizer tool. After that, now sizing required. So each file, how much size will be required. Now see here, so this is a clear cut diagram. So now I have to okay. Now what we understand for this diagram, see here, my operating system size. That is a RAM here. So how much RAM is there totally?
1 TB.
1 terabyte is there. So now the ESR slash SAP is some 5 days. That is even during the installation, you can 50 GB is required.
50 GB.
Okay. Here I want installing as HANA. This is the hard disk. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is the hard disk, and this is for RAM. Okay, see, so yeah, this is the RAM. See how much RAM is required here? Data file.
1.2.
Data and log. What is the purpose of data and log here?
Because so log has to write
backup and recovery. Okay. Mm-hmm. 1/3 of RAM means suppose you have my RAM is 500 GB is there. 500 GB. So how much data log will be able to maintain? 1/2 into the RAM. Okay. Log directly. Okay. Again, now. So here minimum is and maximum terabyte. This is one. Okay.
Okay. Why it is loading in the USR only? It can load another directory also.
No. That is the. This is I'm saying. This is the for even normals. Okay. Normal system done for even RAM. So RAM. This is the majorly this directories are reverse. So don't go for that USR. USR is for even SAP system. Suppose you are installing any SAP. So The HANA DB is different. The HANA database, this is a root slash HANA slash share your directory. Under share, you have to bring in the SIDs. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
This is the direct. This direct is the SAP, front end SAP, that is directory. This is here. This is the HANA slash share your dot SID and SID2. Okay, and remaining say data. So here means HANA, as you can install different SID, like a development, quality, production, like you're installing all the components.
Let's see this. How can I achieve this?
Yeah. Okay, so that's okay. And come back to what, that's why no problem that like what are the formula is there. Even I've seen a compression rate. So in real time, when you without quick size tool, so how we can calculate it? Okay, how to calculate means olden days you're using one formula that is the 2/3 root bit of your database, and the compression rate you can using as a sorry, with existing data, like you say, any other like data fruit into compression rate. The compression rate you can use a 10%, 1% up to your. This is the formula you can use to calculate manually. This is a manual formula. Okay, old and new using, but once the quick size rule 2 is given to picture, the size you can confirm by using quick size 2 only. No need to go for this. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Again, coming to here, sir, as a HANA database, so what are the components you're discussing and what are the topic you're discussing? Again, first of all, you're starting with the architecture. After this, starting with installation. After that, you can go for the architecture. Everything is single process. One in a HANA SAP basis, what are the transactions you're learning? Everything you do, they go for one by one, one by one. So these are the topics. Okay. Already part by the course, you know, so all the topic you can learn together one by one. So I don't know, I had providing the SAP software installing in a machine directly.
Okay, then can I put today downloading?
Yeah, just okay. I'll providing this one second.